Hi there, Doug Stuman with the Supermicro Hyper SuperServer 121H-TNR. This is a 1U server with dual socket support for 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs with up to 64 cores each. At full capacity, it can support up to 8 terabytes of memory. It can also be configured with 12 storage bays compatible with NVMe, SAS, and SATA drive types. Subscribe to our channel if you like our content. There will definitely be more to follow. Let's get to it. Supermicro's Hyper SuperServer line supports 4th and 5th generation CPUs for maximum performance and a high degree of flexibility. They're optimized for AI inference, machine learning, network functions, and virtualization, plus cloud computing and use as an enterprise server. This particular unit only comes as a completely assembled system, so there is no one or two CPUs. You get two, plus a few other items to outfit the system to a minimal capacity, and that includes at least 4 DIMMs, a NIC card, and at least 1 drive. On another note, and not included in that minimal setup, are up to 3 single-wide GPU accelerators or 1 double-wide card. Included in that list is the NVIDIA H100. The control panel in the front features an optional vanity bezel and several LEDs for system status, the power on button, and unit ID button. There's also a USB 3.1 port in the left server ear. 2 basic storage configurations include an 8-bay configuration and a 12-bay setup. The 8-bay version is the default configuration. As an option, you can install 4 more drive bays. The first 8 can be configured with SAS, SATA, or NVMe drive types, with the optional 4 storage bays supporting SATA or NVMe storage devices. With this platform, you can also have a mix of drive types or go exclusively with 1 drive type. Are you interested in the Supermicro Hyper SuperServer 121H-TNR? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information on this platform. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Just think, that 1U dual socket server could be riding shotgun in the car right next to you. Or you could just place it in a server rack, I suppose. On the back of the system, there are dual 1200-watt redundant titanium-level power supply units, a management port, dual USB 2.0 ports, a VGA port, and an advanced I/O module or AIOM slot compatible with OCP 3.0 standards, then 3 PCI ports. There are no integrated LAN ports other than the management port. Supermicro does offer a few management tools to monitor system status with 3 main options. SuperDoctor 5 is for managing a single server. Supermicro Server Manager, or SSM, is for managing several server nodes. Then there's Supermicro SuperCloud Composer, which is relatively new. It delivers a software-defined composable infrastructure. SuperCloud Composer enables administrators to manage the entire infrastructure through a single intuitive user interface and is compatible with Linux and other third-party management tools. SuperCloud allows you to deploy, provision, monitor, and repurpose infrastructure assets on the fly. This option is more of a software container-based system than, say, a traditional hardware asset virtualization-based system like with the Supermicro Server Manager. I might add SSM does require licensing for each target node with either IPMI, Redfish, or SuperDoctor 5 acting as the OS agent. With Supermicro SuperCloud Composer, instead of a server node-based view of your infrastructure, it pulls storage, memory, GPUs, networking, and compute, making for a composable and easy to reconfigure library of assets that can be grouped as needed to reduce complexity. You can also look at a single server or switch and get into some seriously granular detail. It's actually very cool with a brilliant user interface, but I'm not going to get into that right now. Inside the case, the Supermicro 121H-TNR has a dense layout with drive cage up front, in this case only showing the 8-bay backplane. If this was the 12-bay version, there would be an additional shorty backplane right beside it. Just behind the backplane, a bank of 8 counter-rotating fans, then dual CPU sockets with 16 more memory module slots each for a total of 32 slots, and then the 2 risers in back. The one in the middle, riser 1, provides a single full-height, half-length slot with the I/O mezzanine card slot underneath. The other riser has 2 full-height, full-length slots. All slots are PCI 5.0 and feature a x16 slot length with x16 link. Right next to the I/O mezzanine card slot are 2 PCI 3.0 slots for NVMe SATA M.2 drives, which when outfitted with 2 drives can support a RAID for redundancy. As a reminder, each PCI generation doubles the supported bandwidth compared to the previous generation over the same number of PCI lanes. In other words, with a PCI 4.0 x4 slot length and x4 PCI interface, you would get a bandwidth of about 2 gigabytes per second over each lane for a total of up to 8 gigabytes per second transfer rate over that by-4 slot interface. For PCIe 5.0, you can double those values to up to 4 gigabytes per second per lane and up to 16 gigabytes per second over a PCIe 5.0 by-4 slot length with by-4 lanes. All good. As I mentioned earlier, this platform can support GPUs, either one double width card or up to 3 single width cards. Only one supports a PCIe 5.0 interface, the Hopper architecture-based NVIDIA H100 at 80 gigabytes. Other listed GPUs supported on this system include the NVIDIA RTX A5000, RTX A4000, L40S, and the L4. I'd imagine other GPUs are supported given the power draw on that H100 is at 350 watts. They're probably just not tested. The H100, RTX A5000, and L40S are double-width cards, whereas the RTX A4000 and L4 are single-width GPUs. But the A4000 featuring Ampere architecture is billed as the single most powerful single-slot GPU for graphics applications. That L40S is no slouch either, given it is the go-to for AI applications if you can't get the H100 or RTX 6080 GPUs. And no, the RTX 6080 is not on the list, but I think you could add it. There are 8 NVMe connectors on the motherboard for the default configuration with all NVMe drives up front. With a 12-bay setup, you need an additional controller. If you want more RAID options, you would need a controller for that too. This system supports virtual RAID on CPU or VROC for SATA and NVMe drive support, offering limited RAID options of 0, 1, 5, and 10, but does require the Intel VROC key for all of those RAID options. Using a standard key will provide the same RAID, just not RAID 10. If you go with a 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPU, you can get up to 64 cores per CPU, plus increased memory speeds at up to 5600 megatransfers per second. Using 4th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, only up to 60 cores apiece, and memory speeds will top out at 4800 megatransfers per second. For both, top memory speeds are only with 1 DIMM per channel, and each CPU generation does provide 8 memory channel architecture. With 2 DIMMs per channel, you can achieve that top memory capacity of up to 8 terabytes, but memory speeds will be reduced to 4400 megatransfers per second. Only registered DDR5 memory modules are supported. Supporting dual 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, up to 8 terabytes of memory, plus support for NVMe and up to 3 GPUs, the Supermicro Hyper SuperServer 121H-TNR has some pretty impressive credentials. This system can be configured to support a number of business-critical applications, and at only 1U, there's probably some room to squeeze it in with your existing infrastructure. If you want to learn more, I placed a few links below, or you can hit that link right there. If you have any questions, post them in the comments section below. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.